Hello friends, welcome to SS Unitech. My name is Sushil Singh and this is continuation of SQL Server interview questions and answers. So today I wanna discuss one more question which is related to interviews. So this is status failure report. So let's move to another slide where we will discuss about the question. So this is our slide and you can see we have an input table and it contains two columns. First is transaction ID and second is status. And we can see status value is P and F. When it comes fit, then pass, otherwise fail. So we want to get those transaction ID which comes after the status pass. So here we can see we have transaction ID 1, status value is P, and then transaction ID is 2, value is F. So F come after the status pass. So we want to get in our output. As you can see, we have transaction ID 10 and value is fail. Our previous transaction before the 10 is 5 and the status value is pass. So we want to get in our output. So such type of values we want to get in our output which comes after the status pass. So how we can achieve this output by using SQL Server query? So let's move to SQL Server Management Studio where we will write the query to get the output. As I am using SQL 2014, you may have another version of SQL Server. But the query would be same for all the versions. Doesn't matter what version you are using. And I have already created the table and inserted the record on the same. So here we can see we have transaction ID 1, status is pass, and another transaction ID is 2 and status is fail. So 2 would become in our output. So how we can achieve this output? So first of all, we need to understand the logic how we can achieve this. As you can see in our input table we have transaction ID, but transaction ID not in sequence. As you can see, transaction ID is 5, then there is some missing transaction IDs. If we have transaction ID in a sequence, then we can apply a self join and we can get the output. So first of all, we need to create a sequence number. For creating sequence number, we have to use row number. So this is our row number and we have to apply OR clause. And then we can use order by on the behalf of this transaction ID. So this is transaction ID. And now we can execute and we can see we have a column and it has the sequence number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like this. And we can give some alias name is sequence. So now let's assume you have the sequence number as a transaction ID. So copy this and go to Excel to understand the logic how we can get the output. So this is our Excel. I wanna put self join between these two tables. So I have pasted two times. So here we can see, here we can delete this row and this transaction ID as well. So, and now this is our transaction ID. When status value is P, then we will get in our single table like 1, 4, 5, and then we want to apply a join between this and this table, and in this table we want to get only those status which is pass. So here we can see we have 1, 4, 5 and then 8. So now I wanna apply join between these two on the behalf of sequence number. So this sequence number value is 1 is equals to, and here we can see the sequence number value is 2. So we have to compare between our first row from this pass status table and the second row from this other table. So we have to apply this sequence number from left table plus 1. So sequence left plus 1 is equals to sequence right table. So when we apply such type of join, then we can see we will get the output. So now let's move to SQL Server Management Studio to apply join. So now I wanna put this query in a CTE. So we can call this CTE as a CTE main and as keyword. So this is the syntax for the CTE. And now I want to use one more CTE to get our left table as I have displayed here, and in this left table we want to get only those transaction ID which status is pass. So we can put simply comma, and we can use simply nested city and give the city name. So city pass, as we are going to get only those transaction ID which status is pass. So select stick from city main table, city main, and as keyword was missing, where status value is pass. And then we can see select stick from city pass. When we execute this query, we will get those transaction ID which status is pass. So now we have to apply join between city pass and city main. So this is our city main, and we gonna put alias as A, then inner join with city pass as B. On A dot sequence number is equals to B dot sequence number. As we have explained here, our left table is those table which status is pass. So we have to add one in our sequence. So this is our B table. So we have to add plus one, and we want to get only values from main table, and we have to apply a where clause because we want to get those transaction IDs which status is fail. So A dot status value should be fail. And now I want to execute this query, and we can see we are going to get the output as we want. So I want to select the table, so it's very easy to compare between them. Execute, and I'm going to maximize. So here we can see little bit big. Yeah, so here we can see we have 210 and 202. So two value is fail. So here we can see our first value is pass, that is okay. Then 10, so our previous value is 5 and status value is pass. Then 202, so our previous value is pass. So by using this query we can get the output. So I hope you have understand how we can get the output. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel for many more videos and press bell icon to get all the notifications for new videos. If you need this script, it will be available on my Facebook page. You can copy from there. Thank you so much for watching.